So what we're going to talk about is how to do a DNA analysis to determine the paternity between the fathers and the child,
the
hatchlings. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to extract mRNA from the collected tissue sample. So we have mRNA. And then we're going to incubate it with reverse transcriptase, which basically it's going to do the same thing. So we're going to put it in a buffer solution first. It's going to do the opposite of transcription.
What we're going to initially do is that we're going to take a very small sample, or any sample really.
And once it's in the buffer solution, we're going to make single-stranded DNA, which is also known as cDNA.
So
once we do that, we need double-stranded DNA. So we're going to add a primer to it. DNA polymerase, which is basically going to attach to the primer because that's like the starting to make that other complementary strand. We're going to add DNA ligase, which is going to stick these free nucleotides that are all around the buffer solution, and we're going to make another strand. And that's how you have double-stranded DNA. From double-stranded DNA, this is just one molecule of DNA. So we're going to use PCR, which is basically going to replicate the cDNA in order to make many molecules of DNA.
So,
PCR. There's three steps.
You're going to be adding a
in which first you have denaturation
as a small base that is going to be used in the elongation of your DNA. Now, how does this happen again? Well, we're at really high temperatures, so we're going to use a special temperature.
Basically, you have one molecule of DNA, and it's intertwined, but you're going to get it like this because they're going to denaturate, so you're going to have.